Hey YouTube, and welcome to Tell Samira. So today I'm going to talk about vacationing with friends, the good and the bad. Now most of us love a good vacation. You know, the anxiety we get about going to a new place or back to a place that we visited before and had a great time. And it's such a good thing if you can take friends with you and enjoy that. But what about the times when you take that friend with you and you don't enjoy it? You all have such a bad time, you end up questioning your friendship. So today I'm going to give you my stories about some good vacations I had and some bad vacations I had with friends. So to answer it to should you vacation with your friend, it could be yes and it could be no. So let's go ahead and get into it. So one friend I have, I enjoy vacationing with her. She's a travel agent and she's very relaxed and open and allows you to do what you want to do on your vacation. That for me is something I like. I find that in order to have a good vacation with friends, you have to know what you like and be able to express that to your friend. So for instance, we were in somewhere in Mexico and we decided to go on this outing with this guy. He had a truck and he was going to take us around. It was just a lot of trucks there and a lot of vans willing to take vacationers around as soon as we got off the ship. But we didn't know if he was legit. So my friend who is a travel agent, she decided she didn't want to go, but she didn't care if the rest of us went. She just said, hey, I'm going to go ahead and take the license plate number just in case if he's some kind of killer. So she took the license plate number and the rest of us, we went on with him. We had a good time because, you know, if you get off the boat, a lot of times it's just a tourist trap. You don't really get to see the city if you're on a cruise. So we got a chance to drive through the city, went to the beach and went to some shops, had a really good time, and we came back. And so we told her all about it and it was cool. She wasn't one of those kind of people who felt like, oh, the whole group needs to stay together. Everyone has to do the same thing. So that went well for us. And I think I've been on two vacations with her. We've always had a good time. You know, we might do things together. We might do things separately, but it was always okay. Everything was clear. We knew who was paying for what. So it was no confusion about the money. Everything was talked about and, you know, everyone took care of their own bills. It was great, you know, no problems. But, and that's the only time I think I could say I had perfect vacations was with that person. Another time I had a vacation, and this one wasn't really bad. I went to St. Louis with a friend. I had gone to St. Louis before, and I'm the type of person, if I've gone somewhere, I can pretty much map it out and know how to get around it. This was before cell phones was a big thing. So my friend, she went with me. We were having a good time. You know, beforehand, we talked about who was going to pay for what. We decided to split the bill for the hotel room. That's a good thing about vacationing. You know, we split the hotel room. At the time, before Uber and Lyft, we were taking cabs. So we decided beforehand we were going to split the cab. So we got to save money. So, but the problem was when we went to the St. Louis, I think it's called the Arc. And after we got out from the Arc, she wanted to go right and I wanted to go left. I told her, hey, the train is a block away. We came from left. And she's arguing, no, we came from right. I'm going right. Let's go right. And I said, no. And so we kept going back and forth. Yes, no, this way, left, right, left, right. And I said, look, I know I've been here before. Let's go. And I said, it's a block away. And she kept saying, no, I'm going the other direction. And so after arguing with her for like 15 to 20 minutes, I literally sat down the steps in front of the Arch. And I sat down and was trying to talk to her like, no, what are you doing? You're going to get lost. And she was adamant about going the other way. So I let her go. But so I went ahead and walked the block and went to the end of the street. It was, you know, and sat there for the train. I waited a long time thinking she would know after she walked a block right that the train wasn't there and she would turn around and come back and meet me. I missed about two or three trains. She didn't show. I went back to the room. So I'm sitting at the hotel room just hanging out, waiting for her to come back in so I could laugh at her for going the wrong way and for not trusting me. I ended up going to sleep. I woke up. It was dark. When I went to sleep, it was light time. So she had been gone for about 5-6 hours at this time. She did not have a cell phone. I was pretty sure she didn't know the name of the hotel, the phone number, anything. So I was up for a while, and after an hour of being awake, I decided I was going to getting ready to call the police. She ends up coming in the door saying that she should have listened to me. She had went the wrong way, had gotten lost, ended up going into some fast food place talking to people. And they decided to help her out and get her a cab back to the hotel. She remembered the hotel name, and it turns out she was only a block away from the hotel. So the cab literally took her around the corner. And so that was the only thing bad about it. We went to casinos and everything else. We had a really good time. But when we went back home, her sister told me that I should have stayed with her. And I told her sister, I said, no, I shouldn't have stayed with her. Why would I go the wrong way with her? And I kept trying to convince her and even waited on her. Her sister was like, no, but if you're vacationing, you should never split. And I disagree with that. I think, in a vacation, you can split up, and that'll be okay. But, I'm just not going to go the wrong way with somebody. That's just me. Another vacation I had is I was over in Europe studying abroad, and a friend of mine from college decided that she was going to come over and meet me in Paris. And so I ended up flying to Paris, and we had agreed to fly to Paris. We had already mapped out hostels we were going to stay in. Just basically hostels is very cheap living environments. A lot of students and backpackers stay in hostels. So we had already decided who was going to pay what. Of course, she was going to pay for her own ticket. I was paying for mine. We had to pay our individual costs for the hostels, and we would split any costs for cabs. So we had discussed what we wanted, that part in advance. The problem was we did not discuss if we could split up or not, and that's what caused the problem. And it's very important to have a discussion about how this trip is going to go in your head before you actually go on the trip. Because had I had that conversation with her saying, hey, there might be some places I want to go and you don't go, I'm going to split. If you don't like to split up, maybe we shouldn't go on vacation together, because I'm the kind of person, I like to be able to go, and you might want to sleep, and that's not going to work for me. So I want to have a good time. In order for me to have a good time, I want to hit these certain spots, and that may mean may have to split up from you. But I didn't have that conversation with her, because at the time, I didn't know it was needed. So anyway, she was coming from America, and she got over to me. It was probably 6 to 8 hour difference from where she lived in America to where we were in Paris. And so she was jet lagged, meaning she wanted to sleep. And the bad thing for me was she wanted me to stay in the hostel with her while she slept. I guess just reading a book or something. And my dream was to go to Paris. So I didn't want to just go to Paris just to sit in the hostel and sleep. So I told her, hey, I'm going to go and go XYZ and I'll come back. And she was like, oh, no, we shouldn't separate. We need to stay together. Eventually, I think I did go a few places without her, but it was constantly tension because she didn't want me to go, and she was always trying to get me to stay in the room. And even if she did go somewhere with me, we walked around. We would go maybe one place or two places, and then she was yawning and said she wanted to go back to the room. And for me, I felt that that was very selfish. It's like, okay, if you are jet lagged, that's fine, but don't try to hold me back on my dream vacation to Paris. You go and you lay down somewhere, And so it was just, that part of it was not good. But the good part of that vacation with her was that I had someone with me, because we almost got mugged. At night, we decided we wanted to go to the Eiffel Tower to see it lit up. And I came out of the hostel and noticed that two guys were just lingering around looking at the hostel. And I was wondering, like, something doesn't seem right, but I ignored it. She came out and we started walking, and she noticed them and said, once we got to the train, and she said, something doesn't feel right. And I said, oh, I thought the same thing. And so we decided once they jumped on the train, we jumped off and took another train. So we thought that we had dodged them. But we get to the Eiffel Tower, and sure enough, they're there at the Eiffel Tower taking pictures. But I still think that they were some muggers, and because we both had the same feeling. So that's a good thing. Two is better than one, just in case you get a crazy person. Maybe one could be killed and the other one could escape. No, or, the other one can call for help. Let's say that. So, anyway, we decided to take a different route back to the hostel so we could try to avoid the two possible muggers. So we got away from them. So, but that was the good part. She was there to help in the time of possible trouble. I was there for her. We also were able to split some of the bills, and she didn't. She still had. I don't know the name of the Finnish dollar, but she still had some left when she was leaving, and she was nice and decided just to give them to me instead of changing them back to American dollars. But as far as is that someone that I would want a vacation with in the future? No. And after that, we really didn't talk much. And I think it was probably because of that. And we sort of had different lives, and I was at a different school from her. So the friendship just fizzled out. But what I think is a more mature way of doing things is to call a person that you had a bad vacation with and just say, hey, the vacation didn't go well. I was hoping to go more places on my own. I was hoping to see other things, and you were kind of sleepy. And we should have talked about that in the beginning. However, I still want to be friends, but we don't have to vacation together anymore. But I wasn't so sophisticated at the time. So anyway. Another vacation, which I think has to be my worst vacation. My thing is that it's hard for me to find friends that I want to vacation with. It's either I'm going to have a great time with the people I'm vacationing with, or it's going to be so horrible that it just totally ends the friendship. And again, the bad vacations is a lot because things were not discussed up front, is what I've learned. But this next story is probably going to erase what I just said about discussing things up front, because I discussed things up front and this vacation just still went bad, and I'm still concerned about vacationing with friends because of this. So I was going to church with these two ladies, and we had decided we were going to go to New York, but one of them ended up having financial difficulties while we were making the plan, so she decided not to go. So the other lady told the one with no money that she would pay for her. And I'm thinking, I'm from that school of thought, if you ain't got no money, keep your broke ass home, but apparently they weren't. So the one person was going to pay for the other friend, and I made myself clear. I said, if she's going, I still want to split everything three ways, because I just didn't think it was fair for her to be there, and then we're splitting the gas two ways instead of three, and it's three people here, or it's, we were going to get a rental car. Let's split it three ways, because the other girl said she was paying for everything for the other girl. So if you're paying, that means to me. And I discussed this up front. I said, if you're paying for her, that means we're all paying a third for the room. We're paying a third for gas. If we have any parking, we're paying a third. We're paying a third for the hotel room. And they both said yes. The only thing we didn't discuss was that, and all three of us were going to take turns driving the car. And I went over that with them like two times. And they said, yes, that's fine. So when it came time to go, everything was good. We got to where we were staying. We were staying in somewhere in, what was it, Elizabeth, New Jersey, not too far from New York City. We stayed there because it was cheaper, and we want to save some money. So the first problem was I didn't tell them that I wanted to go alone some places alone if they weren't ready. Because we got there, and I'm the type of person, I'm like a kid for Christmas. I'm very excited to be there. I'm not trying to sleep all day. I'm ready to go. So we got there. They wanted to sleep. They wanted to be refreshed. That's fine. But don't try to make me stay at the hotel with you while you want to sleep. Now, this is, I think we didn't, I don't think we had the cell phones at the time. I'm not sure. We might have. I think we did. But anyway. So I'm ready to go. And that was the problem. They didn't want me to go. They wanted me to stay with them. So then they said, okay, they'll hurry up and get ready. It took them forever to get ready because they were sleepy. And so we finally get to the train. So we get to the train. We already missed one train because they're so slow. And then we get there and we're waiting for a train. Then they decide, oh, they need snacks. And I told them, hey, let's wait until we get into the city because the train will be here in about 2 minutes. They're saying, oh no, Samira, it'll take a second. They go, and as soon as they leave, the train comes, so we miss it, and we had to wait a long time for the next train. So I'm already getting irritated, but I'm like trying to bring it down. Okay, okay. So it was some good things. We had fun times walking around together. Good, like I said, it was three of us. We were on the trains. We were having fun just talking to the people in New York. So that's the good things. You can have people to talk to who you already know. You know, sharing stories, having just, you know, a great time walking around, seeing new sights. But then the bad part is, one of the days while we were there, we eventually met up with my aunt. And then we went to go someplace to eat with her. And when the bill came, the two girls I was with, they were hesitant. Like, I don't know, like they were waiting for something. And I'm thinking, why won't they just pay their bill? And my aunt had said she was taking over my bill. And my aunt had to say it twice. So once we left the place, my two friends were walking in front of us. And my aunt said to me, she said, yeah, I don't know what's up with them too, but she said, I got the feeling that they thought that I was about to pay their bills too. And I said, yeah, something didn't seem right with that. I don't know why they were hesitating when the bill came. And when the waitress asked, you know, about them, if they were paying their bill, they didn't say anything. They were just looking around like at my aunt, you know. And so she said, I don't know what that was about, but that was weird. And I said, yeah, I guess. You know, so, you know, we had went to Harlem and we just got our hair done. So those are the good things anyway. So the part where it got really bad is on the way back, going back home, we were driving in the car. We got to a gas station. I was irritated because it just seemed like it was a lot of little things with them. Like they kept, you know, getting up late, wanting to stay in the hotel a lot, and then they kept getting mad at me. So I just had a bit of an attitude. I was just ready to get away from them after about 3 or 4 days. So one of the ladies, they were both out pumping the gas, and one of the ladies said to me, Samira, it seems you have a problem. You know, if you have something to say, you should just say it. And I said, you know, I'm just really tired, but what are you talking about? And then she said, they got in the car, and the woman who said she was going to pay everything for the other lady starts telling me that she felt that I wasn't paying my share. And I said, what do you mean? I've been paying a third this whole way. And she says, no, you were supposed to be paying half. I said, I told you both that I was only paying a third. I said that twice and both of you agreed. And I asked the other lady, I said, you heard me say that. So I said, right. She was like, don't put me in it. Samira, if you got a thing about money, you should have just said something. You know, and looking back, I see that they were just trying to gang up on me, and maybe they had this conversation before because they couldn't have been in their right mind. So we were going back and forth, and I'm like, what are you talking about? I had the conversation with you both. So they just kept going back, trying to make it seem like I was trying to be shady with the money and not paying. And I said, look, I would have never come if I didn't have the money. I told you I was not paying for you. I'm not in a you know, business of paying for people, and that's your responsibility. You should have took care of yourself. So again, they kept on trying to blame me. And then the one who was supposed to be paying for the other lady started telling me that she really had paid a certain amount for the car, way more than she told me, you know. And I said, look, okay, that's on you and all this other stuff. I said, I'll give you some more money on this car. But I said, first off, you shouldn't have lied. And I said, you lied about this whole thing. And you know, and really what I think it was is that she went to Chinatown. We all went, and she bought tons of purses, tons of jewelry, watches, because she had planned to sell it back to someone else, you know, to other people when she got home and make a profit. And I think maybe she just spent too much money and thought she was going to get some money out of me. I don't know what scam they were running. But anyway, after that, the relationship with both of them had changed. With the one who said she was going to pay, we didn't have like a strong relationship, but it was good and friendly, and we were on the same committees together. After that, it was basically just high and bye. The other girl before that, we were friends and we would hang out with each other, but it was already starting not to be so great, and maybe I should have considered that before I went on vacation with her. It was some things about her that concerned me, you know. So yeah, don't go on vacations with anybody you got red flags about. So after I went on a after the vacation with her, it was just a high and by at the church. It was even so bad that even her dad came to visit the church, and he said to me, "Oh, Samira, you used to come over our house all the time before New York. What happened?" And since it really was none of his business, I just said, "Oh, you know, I'm busy." He was like, "Mm-hmm." So, you know, that's why I said it can be good and it could be bad. Again, the good is in vacationing with somebody, you can have some protection in case of, and you can split some of the costs, you know, and if you really enjoy that person's company, you know, why not enjoy the company in Paris or Italy, Bahamas, or wherever you are. And, but it's very important. You got to tell people what you expect. Who's going to pay for what, you know, what sort of places are you going to see? Is it okay with them if you go somewhere without them? And if not, maybe you want to consider if that's a person you want to vacation with. And, some people, like I said earlier, you can still remain friends with them, but that does not mean you have to vacation with them. So again, this is Tell Samira. Have a good one. Oh, also, if you have any comments, good or bad vacations, leave them down in the comments section. Any questions you have, let me know. Don't forget to like this video and to subscribe.